أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألم تر إلى ربك كيف مد الظل ولو شاء لجعله ساكنا ثم جعلنا الشمس عليه دليلا ثم قبضناه إلينا قبضا يسيرا. صدق الله العظيم. Don't you see how your Lord prolongs the shadows? In the morning, you know, when the sun is just risen, the shadows are very long, very long. But then as the sun keeps up rising higher and higher, now the shadow is becoming smaller and smaller. This phenomenon is referred here. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَيْفَ مَدَّ الظِّلْ. How he prolongs the shadow. وَلَوْ شَاءَ لَجَعَلَهُ سَاكِنًا. Had he willed so, he would have made it stationary. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَا الشَّمْسَ عَلَيْهِ دَلِيلًا. But then it becomes according to the sun. It moves according to the sun. The sun rising higher and higher, and this becoming smaller and smaller. ثُمَّ قَبَضْنَاهُ إِلَيْنَا قَبْضًا يَسِيرًا. Then we draw it towards ourselves very easily. When, you know, sun is on the top, now there is no shadow, nearly no shadow. Then again when the sun is now going down, there is a shadow. And as it is going down and down, the shadow will again be prolonged. وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا. And it is he who has made the night for you a cover or garment. وَالنَّوْمَ سُبَاتًا. And he has made this sleeping for you a repose. وَجَعَلَ النَّهَارَ نُشُورًا. And he has made the day for you so that you should get up and go this side or that side. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ الرِّيَاحَ بُشْرًا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ رَحْمَتِهِ. And it is he who sends winds as bearers of the great, of the glad news before his mercy. His mercy is coming, rain is going to come. But before the rain comes, this cool breeze comes to give you a good news that the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near to descend. وَنزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً طَهُورًا. And then we send down pure water from the heaven. لِنُحْيِيَ بِهِ بَلْدَةً مَيْتًا. So that we may give life by this water to the dead land. وَنُسْقِيَهُ. And then we make people drink it. مِمَّا خَلَقْنَا أَنْعَامًا وَأَنَاسِيَ كَثِيرًا. It is given to drinking for those who have we have created, many cattle and many human beings. وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَاهُ بَيْنَهُمْ لِيَذَّكَّرُوا. And we certainly have explained our things in many styles, many ways. لِيَذَّكَّرُوا. So that they get the admonition. فَأَبَا أَكْسَرُ النَّاسِ إِلَّا كُفُورًا. But most of the mankind refuse but disbelief and ingratitude. وَلَوْ شَيْنَا لَبْعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ قَرْيَةٍ نَذِيرًا. And had we willed, we could have sent to every city, every town, a warmer. فَلَا تُطْعِي الْكَافِرِينَ وَجَاهِدْهُمْ بِهِ جِهَادًا كَبِيرًا. This ayah is very important. So you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't obey the disbelievers, but strive against them in the strongest way with this Qur'an. This is Makki surah. The word jihad has come over here. So jihad was going on in the Makki days also. But this was not the jihad with the sword, which became there in the Madani period. Jihad with sword, that is qital, going to war. But at Makkah, the jihad was being made with Quran. Jahidhum bihi jihadan kabira. Now this is the sword. With that sword made of iron, you kill a person. But with this sword of Quran, you kill the wrong ideas, the wrong beliefs. These things, you know, they are killed by the sword of Quran. So, فَلَا تُطْعِ الْكَافِرِينَ. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't obey these disbelievers. And وَجَاهِدْهُمْ. Continue striving against them. بِهِ. With this Quran. جِهَادًا كَبِيرًا. A striving very great and very hard. وَهُوَ الَّذِي مَرَجَ الْبَحْرَيْنِ. And he is who has made two currents to flow side by side. هَذَا عَزْبٌ فُرَاتٌ وَهَذَا مِلْهُ الْعُجَاجِ. This one is sweet and palatable water. And part of the other current is saltish and bitter. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَهُمَا بَرْزَقًا وَحِجْرًا مَحْجُورًا. And he has set a barrier and a formidable partition, forbidding partition between them. The waters cannot intermingle. A current of water is flowing, and side by side the other is flowing. In one it is sweet water, in the other it is bitter water, but they don't intermingle with each other, as if there is some curtain in between which cannot be seen, invisible current. وَهُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ مِنَ الْمَاءِ بَشَرًا. And he is who created man from water. I've explained it many times that the life is from water. Our bodies have come up from the clay, the mud, صَلْصَالِ مِنْ حَمَيْ مَسْنُونَ مِنْ تِينَ مِنْ تُرَابَ, and so on and so forth. But the life, source of life is water. فَجَعَلَهُ نَصْبًا وَالسِّهْرًا. And then we have made for him relations by blood and by marriage. وَكَانَ رَبُّكَ قَدِيرًا. And definitely your Lord has been all-powerful. وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ وَلَا يَذُرُّهُمْ. And they are worshipping besides Allah those who cannot give them any benefits or profits, nor they can harm them. وَكَانَ الْكَافِرُ عَلَىٰ رَبِّهِ زَهِيرًا. But the disbeliever, he has become a party against the Lord. He is helping and supporting the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا مُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. This thing has come many a times, and we have not sent you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except as a bearer of glad tidings and as a warner. قُلْ مَا أَرْسَلْكُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ عَجْرٍ إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ سَبِيلًا. إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ سَبِيلًا. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I don't ask you for any reward or wage. My only intention is that whosoever amongst you wants to take the straight path to his Lord, he should be able to take it. I am only explaining the right path to you, so that it is possible for whomsoever wants and decides to take that right path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he may be able to do it. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ. And O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, put all your trust in him who is the living, ever-living, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا يَمُوتُ, who will never die. وَصَبِّعْ بِحَمْدِهِ. And glorify him with his praise. وَكَفَى بِذُنُوبِ عِبَادِهِ خَبِيرًا. And he is sufficient to know the sins of his bondsmen and his servants. الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا. The one who has created the heavens and the earth and whatever is in between them, فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ, in 6 days. 6 cycles of time. We can't know what was the duration of one day. But somehow the 6th number must be there. A time will come when science will reveal this. The 6 periods of time were taken in the creation of this universe. ثُمَّ اسْتَوَىٰ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. Then he mounted the throne. Ar-Rahman, he is Rahman, he is the compassionate. Fas'al bihi khabira. So you can ask about him those people who have some knowledge. I told you that this name of Allah, Rahman, it was not known by the Arabs, the Mushrikeen, the Ummiyin, the Bani Ismail. They only knew one word, Allah. Allah was an ancient name. But Quran introduced another names, other names, so many names. Lahul Asma'ul Husna, all the good names are for him. But among the other names, Ar-Rahman has been emphasized the most in Quran. Now these mushrikeen used to say, who is this Rahman? We don't know him. So it is being said here, if you don't know, you ask those who have the knowledge. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ اسْجُدُوا لِلرَّحْمَنِ قَالُوا أَبَا الرَّحْمَنِ. And when it is said to them, you should prostrate before Rahman, they say, who is this Rahman? أَنَسْجُدُ لِمَا تَعْمُرُنَا. Should we prostrate before him whom you are asking us to prostrate? وَزَادَهُمْ نَفُورًا. And then there is increase in their aversion. They go away. This is the ayah of sajda. So please make the sajda. تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا. Blessed is he who has set in the heaven constellations. وجعل فيها سراجا. And placed in them a lamp, that is the sun. وقمرا منيرا. And a shining moon. وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة. And it is he who has made the night and day coming after each other. لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. For those who desire to be admonished and those who desire to be grateful. By looking these things, the phenomena of the nature, there should be two results. Number one, you should know Allah, how powerful He is, what a creator He is, what He has created. So this is admonition, tazakkur, that you have the idea of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your hearts and minds. And second is shukr. You must be grateful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set this alternation of night and day. And with this, you know, all vegetation, all plant kingdom is tied to this process. Their respiration cycle is reversed. During the day it is something else, during the night it is something else. And all this system, you know, it is attached to this alternation of night and day. And then we take rest during the night so that we are rejuvenated, revitalated, and then we can work the other day with zeal. So shukr and zikr, those who want to be admonished and those who want to be grateful. وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. Now this section of this surah, last section, it is very important. It's also one lesson of the selected course of study of Quran that I mentioned before also. We have read in the beginning of Surah Al-Mu'minun, the foundations on which the character of a mu'min can be built. Now here we are finding some glimpses of the character of a mu'min, mature character, who is fully mature. Now what are his properties and what are his signs? What is his attitude? What is his feeling? So this thing actually, a fully mature and developed human, a mu'min personality. And Allah calls them Ibadur Rahman, the bondsmen of Rahman. The dear bondsmen of Rahman, Ibadur Rahman al-lazina yamshuna ala al-ardi hawna. They are those who walk on the earth with humility, not with arrogance. They always think that we are bondsmen, we are servants, we are created by Allah. So this haughtiness, it doesn't touch them. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. And when the ignorant people try to engage them in dialogue or argument, they say, no, salam. We don't want to engage into any argument with you because you are not ready to understand. It's only this argument for the sake of argument. It's no use. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. And those who pass their nights standing and prostrating for their lords. Now there in Surah Al-Mu'minun we found the five obligatory prayers. قَدَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. And in the end, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. These are the obligatory prayers. But here it is the night prayer, which is not obligatory. Tahajjud, which is additional. Although for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was fard, it was obligatory. But for none else it is obligatory. But person who has reached nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spiritually, he prays during the night. Sometimes he is standing and reciting Quran before his Lord. And sometimes he is prostrating. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ. And those who say, O our Lord, avert from us the chastisement of the hell. إِنَّ عَذَابَهَا كَانَ غَرَامًا. Surely its chastisement is an everlasting affliction. إِنَّهَا سَاءَتْ مُسْتَقَرًّا وَمُقَامًا. And hell is definitely a very evil place for permanent, as a permanent abode, as well as a temporary halt. We have in this world, you know, the worst place, but if you have to go and just visit, you will have a recreation. You have seen these things. But if you have to live there, then it is, you know, awful. And the best places in this world, when you go as a visitor, you find very fine. But ask the people who are living over there. Ask the people of Switzerland or Kashmir, do they see any beauty in the land? No. So this Jahannam is very bad, very bad, very bad, not only as a permanent abode, but also as a temporary, for a temporary stay and halt. And we shall find the reverse about paradise, about Jannah, in the end of this section. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَنْفَقُوا لَمْ يُسْرِفُوا وَلَمْ يَقْتُرُوا وَكَانَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ قَوَامًا. And those who, when they spend, they are neither extravagant nor niggardly, but they take a way which is in between. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدْ آخَرَ. And those who don't call upon, besides Allah, any other God. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. And they don't slay the soul, the human life, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden, except by the legal right. If somebody has killed somebody, well, then he can be killed as a punishment, and so on and so forth. But without any guilt, without any, you know, legal right, they don't kill. وَلَا يَزْنُونَ. And then they don't commit adultery. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَ. These are the three biggest sins. The biggest sins, three. Number one, to call upon any other God except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one. And that is the worst. We have read in Surah An-Nisa twice the ayah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ وَيُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءَ. This shirk is such a great sin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never forgive it. But He can, He may, if He likes, He can forgive the smaller sins, but not shirk. So number one is shirk. Number two, to kill a person, human being, without any reason, without any legal right. And number three, adultery. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَى أَصْحَابًا. Whosoever indulges in these things, he will have the punishment. يُضَعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. On the day of judgment, their chastisement will be doubled. This ayah is very important in the Quran, because through this ayah we understand that before the day of judgment also some azab is to come to the disbelievers. This azab al-qabr. Some people say, you know, especially those who don't give any importance to the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that there's no mention of azab al-qabr. All these ahadith, you know, they are baseless. No, it is here. يُضَعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Their punishment, their chastisement would be doubled on the day of judgment. It means they had been having some chastisement before also. وَيَخْلُدْ فِيهِ مُحَانَا. And then he will live, stay there, humiliated forever. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ. But there is an escape. Except those who repent, number one, وَآمَنَا. And then they have the faith, the real belief they renew their faith, renew their conviction. وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. And then they go do good deeds. So three steps. Repentance, why I have done this? I should not have done this. Oh my Lord, I'm ashamed. I should not have done this, number one. Then because, you know, a sin denotes that your belief in Allah was weak when you committed this sin. If the belief was there strong, you could not do any wrong thing. Because that belief, that iman, that faith had decreased in intensity, only then you could commit a sin. So now you have to renew your iman, renew your faith. And what is the proof that the faith has been renewed? Amal salih. Now your deeds should be good. Illa man taba wa amana wa amila amalan salihan fa ulaika yubaddilu Allahu sayyi'atihim hasanat. So such are the people whose vices Allah will turn into virtues. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمًا. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever been forgiving and merciful. وَمَنْ تَعْبَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. And again, you know, emphasizing, instead of three things, two things, first and the last. Whosoever repents and then does good deeds. Now you are repenting and repenting and repenting, you know, and you are repeating, Astaghfirullah Rabbi min kulli zambin wa atubu ilayhi, 1,000 times. I have done 10 tasbih of istighfar. To what use? If your actions are the same, you are indulging in the same sins, you are indulging in riba as you were indulging before, you are indulging now even. So what's the use of these, you know, 10 tasbihat of istighfar? Useless. وَمَنْ تَعْبَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Whosoever repents, and then he rectifies his deeds. فَإِنَّهُ يَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَتَابًا. So he is the one who actually turns to Allah as he should turn. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهَدُونَ الزُّورِ. And those who don't bear false witness. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا. And when they, perchance, they pass by foolish indulgences or vain talking, then they pass from there in a very with dignity. They don't get involved in that. You are going and you saw, you know, something is happening over there. Useless thing. Don't stand and watch it. No, leave it. If it has no benefit for your world, I told you that every second of human life is precious. Either it should be used so as some need of this world is fulfilled. Need, real need. Or it should be used to get the reward in the hereafter. Not to use it for vain things, waste it. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِّرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ لَمْ يَخِرُّوا عَلَيْهَا سُمَّا وَعُدْيَانَا. And those who are admonished, when they are admonished by the revelations of their Lord, they don't fall on it deaf and dumb, deaf and blind. And this is a taunt actually on the kuffar, on the disbelievers. When the revelation was recited unto them, they would never think upon it, nor ponder over it. But they will start, you know, differing and criticizing and mocking and laughing, as if they are deaf and blind. وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ. And those who keep on praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O our Lord, give us, grant us, from our wives and children, the coolness of our eyes, and make us the leaders of the God-fearing. It doesn't mean that you should aspire for leadership. What it means is that you are the natural leader of your family. Your wife, your children, your sons and daughters, when on the day of judgment you are resurrected, behind you will be coming your sons and daughters. So they should be muttaqi people. They should be God-fearing. So then you'll be very happy. Otherwise, if behind you are coming different type of people, you know, your son, but he was a disbeliever. He was, you know, not a man of good character. So here it is, the dua is that you make us lead the God-fearing people. People who are behind us, they should be God-fearing. Ulaika yujzawna al-ghurfata bima sabaru. These are the people who will be rewarded with the highest places in the paradise. For they endured patiently and persevered in the way of Allah. وَيُلَقَّوْنَ فِيهَا تَحِيَّةً وَسَلَامًا. And they will be welcomed there with, they will be received there with greetings and salutations. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. And then they will abide in it forever. حَسَنَتْ مُسْتَقَرًّا وَمُقَامًا. Now this is the reverse of سَاعَتْ مُسْتَقَرًّا وَمُقَامًا. Hell is سَاعَتْ مُسْتَقَرًّا وَمُقَامًا. A very bad place for permanent stay as well as for a temporary halt. But Jannah, paradise, is a very good place for the permanent residence also and for a small visit also. So you have, you might have the best place, but if you have to stay over there or permanently, then it will lose all charm. Now you will find, you know, these are the faults here, these things are difficult here. But you know, if you visit, you find very fine Kashmir, Switzerland. But ask the people who live there, is there any beauty for them in these things? The hardships, they will be complaining. There's winter, there's this thing, there's that difficulty for us. So these things, but Jannah is something which is good for permanent abode as well as a temporary stay. And the hell is very bad, very bad. Even if you are thrown in it for a second, it will show you all its, you know, evil and wickedness. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا حَسُنَتْ مُسْتَقَرًا وَمَقَامًا. قُلْ مَا يَعْبَأُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاؤُكُمْ. Say to them, my Lord doesn't care for you. Don't think that because I am, you know, pursuing you, I am coming to you to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that Allah cares for you. Allah needs you. Ma'azha Allah, no. قُلْ مَا يَعْبَوْ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاؤُكُمْ. But only the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sunnah, the law is that before punishing, He has taken upon Himself to warn and to call them to the right path. That is why I am fulfilling that condition and that's all. Don't think that Allah cares for you. فَقَدْ كَذَّبْتُمْ. Now you have denied. So, فَصَوْفَ يَكُونُ لِزَامًا. Now soon it will become inevitable punishment. Now we come to Surah Ash-Shu'ara. This surah is the largest Makki surah regarding the number of ayat. 227. But it has only 11 sections. Actually, one thing if you keep in mind, that the Makki surahs, we can divide them into three periods. 12 years of stay at Makkah after the beginning of Wahi and before the Hijrah. And we can divide them in equal three parts. First 4 years, middle 4 years, last 4 years. In the first 4 years, the surahs which were revealed, they have very small ayat. There is a music, divine music. There is a fast flow. Ayat are small. These are the three qualities of the ayat of the surahs which were revealed in the first 4 years. Then in the middle 4 years, now ayat are becoming larger and larger. Now that melody is not so apparent. That music is not so apparent. It is there, but not so apparent. And then in the final four years, they are mostly like the Madani surahs. Ayat are very large. And you know, there is a flow, but that flow is like the flow of a river, not, you know, the ocean, you know. So these are the qualities. Then the surahs which were revealed in the first 4 years, they are included in the last two groups of Makki Madani surahs, mostly. And the surahs which were revealed in the middle 4 years, they are included in the middle two groups of the surahs, Makki or Madani surahs groups. And the surahs which were revealed in the last 4 years, they were the those surahs which were included in the first two groups, An'am, Araf, two, and then from Yunus, Hud, etc., etc., to Suratul Mu'minun. But there are certain, you know, exceptions to these rules. Suratul Hijr in the second group. That belongs to, as regards revelation, to the first four-year period. In the same way, this Suratul Shu'ara, although it is included in the middle two groups, but it belongs to the period, as regards revelation, to the period of first 4 years. It has all the qualities, small ayat, rhythm, flow, and a music, divine music, we should say. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Taseem Meem. Tilka ayatul kitab al mubeen. These are the ayat of the clear book, manifest book. لَعَلَّكَ بَاقِ النَّسَّكَ اللَّهَ يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Maybe, O Muhammad, you are going to kill yourself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, due to grief that they are not believing. Such was the grief of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they are not listening to me even. What to speak of accepting my da'wah? إِنْ نَشَأْ نَزِلْ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. If we wish, we can send down on them a sign from the heaven. فَظَلَّتْ عَنَاقُهُمْ لَهَا قَادِعِينَ. So then, their necks would remain bored in humility. Because they used to say, show us a miracle. If you claim that you are a messenger just as Jesus and Moses, you have to show us the miracles. Because you yourself say that such and such and such and such miracles were given to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And even greater miracles were given to Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. So show us the miracle. We have, you know, discussed this subject in Surah Al-An'am. Allah had decided we are not going to show them any such evident and visible miracle. The real miracle of Muhammad is this Quran. Nobody in the past also believed because of miracles. The Jews never accepted Hazrat Isa as the messenger, seeing all the biggest possible miracles were given to Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. Then 9 miracles were given to Hazrat Musa, but Pharaoh didn't come to believe. So there's no use. But if we show such a miracle, then their term will come to an end. And then, you know, the punishment will start. So Allah is kind to them. He wants to extend their term. Maybe if they have not understood now, maybe they understand tomorrow. So it is the kindness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He is not showing such a visible and evident miracle. But if you like, we can send any miracle, any sign at any time. وَمَا يَعْتِهِمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِ مِنَ الرَّحْمَانِ مُحْدَسِمْ إِلَّا كَانُوا أَنْهُمْ مُرَدِينَ. And there doesn't come to them a new admonition, but they turn away. They don't listen to it. فَقَدْ كَذَّبُوا. So they have now belied. فَسَيَعْتِيهِمْ أَنْبَاءُ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَعْزِيُونَ. And soon now, they will have the tidings of what they used to mock at. Oh, azab will come. Oh, Muhammad, why don't you bring it? Bring it soon. But then, the time will come. They will see that chastisement with their eyes. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا إِلَى الْأَرْضِ كَمْ أَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ كَرِيمٍ. Have not they seen to the earth how much we have caused to grow the noble kinds of things in it? إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَةِ. In that is the sign. This nature is full of signs. These phenomena of the nature, each one of them is a big sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Shaykh Sadi says, بَرْغِ دَرَخْتَانِ سَبْزْ دَرْ نَدَرِ هُوشِيَارِ هَرْ وَرَقِ دَفْتَرَسْتَزْ مَعْرِفَتِ كِرْدِگَارِ. The leaves of the grain trees, the green leaves of the trees, each one of these leaves is a big sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But for those who ponder over this, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَةَ وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. But most of them are not going to believe. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. And definitely your Lord is all-powerful, but He is also merciful. This is the place where with Al-Aziz, Al-Rahim is being repeated. Mostly with Al-Aziz, Al-Hakim is repeated in Quran. This pair of two names, Al-Aziz, Al-Hakim. But here, Al-Aziz wa Al-Rahim. Because it is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is not sending down any visible miracle. Because if He does so, their term will come to an end. And then, you know, the matter will be decided for them. وَإِذْ نَادَى رَبُّكَ مُوسَىٰ. أن اتق قوم الظالمين. And remember, when your Lord called upon Musa عليه السلام, that go to the evil doing people, قوم فرعون, that is me, I mean the people of فرعون, ألا يتقون, do they not fear? قال ربي إني أخاف أن يكذبون. Musa said, O my Lord, I fear that they will belie me. ويضيق صدري, and my chest shrinks. Why? ولا ينطلق لساني, and my tongue is also not fluent. So I fear, and due to fear, my chest shrinks. فأرسل إلى هارون. So send for Harun. You should assign this mission to Harun. وَلَهُمْ عَلَيَّ زَمُّنْ, and they have a crime against me. I had killed one of them. And so, فَأَخَافُ أَنْ يَقْتُلُونَ, I fear that when I go, return to them, they will kill me, because I had killed a person. That we shall find in the next surah, Suratul Qasas, the whole story of how an Egyptian was killed by Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. قَالَكَ اللَّهُ, the reply from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, no. فَذْهَبَا, now go both of you. Granted that Harun will accompany you. فَذْهَبَا بِآيَاتِنَا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ مُسْتَمِعُونَ, now go with our signs and we shall be with you listening. فَأْتِيَا فِرْعَوْن, now go to Fir'aun. فَقُولَا, and say, both of you, إِنَّا رَسُولُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, we are the messenger of the Lord of the worlds. أَنْ أَرْسِلْ مَعَنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ, the demand is, now let Bani Israel go with us. قَالَ أَلَمْ نُرَبِّكَ فِينَا وَلِيدًا, now Fir'aun says, didn't we raise you up and we brought you up in our household when you were an infant? You came to our palace as an infant, as a child. We brought you up. So this is the reward that you are giving us? أَلَمْ نُرَبِّكَ فِينَا وَلِيدًا وَلَبِثْتَ فِينَا مِنْ عُمُرِكَ بِسْنِينَ, and you lived with us several years of your life. فَفَعَلْتَ فَعَلَتَكَ الَّتِي فَعَلْتَ, and then you did that crime which you committed. وَأَنْتَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ, and you were from among the very ungrateful people. قَالَ فَعَلْتُهَا إِذَنْ وَأَنَا مِنَ الضَّالِّينَ, Musa said, yes, I committed that mistake. But at that time, I was myself ignorant one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had not at that time, till that time, given me this position of prophethood and messengerhood. So that mistake was committed by me. فَفَرَرْتُ مِنْكُمْ لَمَّا خِفْتُكُمْ, so I ran away from them, from you, to save my life, because at that time I was fearing you. فَوَهَبَ لِي رَبِّي حُكْمًا, now my Lord has given me a command. وَجَعَلَنِي مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ, and he has made me one of the messengers. وَتِلْكَ نِعْمَةٌ, now is coming the reply. When Fir'aun had said, we brought you up in our house when you were only a child. Now the reply is coming, وَتِلْكَ نِعْمَةٌ تَمُنُّهَا عَلَيَّ, you are mentioning your favor to me that you brought me up in your palace. أَنْ عَبَّدْتَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ, and you just forget that you have made whole of my nation Bani Israel slave. You made all the Bani Israel slave. But if you could, you know, bring up one child from among the Bani Israel, you are mentioning it as a very big favor done to me. قَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ وَمَا رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ, Fir'aun said, and who is this رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ, the Lord of the all the worlds? قَالَ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا, Musa replied, the Lord of the heavens and the earth and whatever is in between them, إِن كُنْتُمْ مُوْقِنِينَ, if you are to be convinced. قَالَ لِمَنْ حَوْلَهُ وَلَا تَسْتَمِعُونَ, now he said to the chieftains and the courtiers who were around him, addressing them, لِمَنْ حَوْلَهُ وَلَا تَسْتَمِعُونَ, are you listening to what this man is saying? Are you listening? This very, you know, baseless thing that he is saying. قَالَ رَبُّكُمْ وَرَبُّ آبَائِكُمُ الْأَوَّلِينَ, But Musa continues, he is your Lord and also the Lord of your forefathers of the ancient times. قَالَ إِنَّ رَسُولَكُمُ الَّذِي أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ لَمَجْنُونَ. Again he is addressing his courtiers, his chieftains. Verily this messenger which has been sent to you seems to be mad. He has gone crazy. His mental balance is not correct. قَالَ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ رَبُّ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. But Hazrat Musa is continuing. He is the Lord of the East and the Lord of the West and the Lord of everything which is in between the East and West. إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. Only if you can understand. قَالَ لَيْنِ اتَّخَصْتَ إِلَهًا غَيْرِي لَأَجْعَلْنَكَ مِنَ الْمَسْجُونِينَ. Now he says, you know, as a king, if you take anybody, anyone else as God, except me, لَأَجْعَلَنَّكَ مِنَ الْمَسْجُونِينَ, I will throw you in the prison. I will imprison you. I have told you he was like a younger brother to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. The father had, you know, given up the throne because of old age. But now he was the Fir'aun. Although the senior Fir'aun was also alive, he had not died. But now the ruler was this junior Fir'aun. And he did respect and love Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam because they were brought up together in the palace. But now, regarding, you know, the empire and, you know, their system, they have to defend them. They want status quo, no change. قَالَ لَيْنِ اتَّخَصْتَ إِلَهًا غَيْرِي. And, you know, they people said that we are the Lord. أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْعَلَىٰ. All this country, Egypt, is in my hands. أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرِ وَحَذِي الْأَنْهَارُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِي. The government of Egypt is in my hand. And all the irrigation system is under my control. So I am the Lord. I don't know any other Lord for you except me. لَيْنِ اتَّخَصْتَ إِلَهًا غَيْرِي لَأَجْعَلَنَّكَ مِنَ الْمَسْجُونِينَ. قَالَ وَلَوْ جَيْتُكَ بِشَيْءٍ مُبِينٍ. Now Musa said, although I might bring to you a very clear sign, قَالَ فَاتِ بِهِ إِن كُنْتَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. Fir'aun said, okay, Leo, bring forth. If you are truthful, bring forth the sign that you have. فَأَلْقَى عَصَاهُ فَإِذَا هِيَ صَعْبَانٌ مُبِينٌ. Now he put down his staff and it became a serpent, clearly visible serpent. وَنَدَعَ يَدَهُ فَإِذَا هِيَ بَيْضَاءُ لِلنَّاظِرِينَ. And then he took out his hand from his bosom and for those who were seeing, it became white, shining. قَالَ لِلْمَلَأِ حَوْلَهُ. Now Fir'aun said to the chieftains, chiefs and the courtiers around him, إِنَّ هَذَا لَصَاحِرٌ عَلِيمٌ. Indeed, he is a big sorcerer, big magician. He is showing these things, you know, due to his magic and sorcery. يُرِيدُ أَن يُخْرِجَكُم مِّنْ أَرْضِكُم بِسَحْرِهِ. Now he wants to drive you out of your land due to on the basis of his magic. فَمَاذَا تَعْمُرُونَ. So now what do you say? What do you recommend? What's your opinion? What we should do? But keep one thing in mind. These people, the Egyptians, they were fearing that these Bani Israel are multiplying in number, like anything. As you find the fear today in the West, that our growth, population growth is very slow. And the population growth of the third world is very high. So what will happen? In England, the Englishmen think that these immigrants who have come over here, the Indians and West Indies, etc., etc., they will become more in number in some time and we shall be overpowered by them. In this same way, they were thinking that these Bani Israel can be a challenge and threat for us. So, he said, now, in addition to the great numbers that they are in, now he has this magic also. So with this magic and their number, maybe they can drive us out from our land. So what is your opinion? فَمَاذَا تَعْمُرُونَ. قَالُوا أَرْجِهْ وَأَخَاهُ وَبْعَثْ فِي الْمَدَائِنِ حَاشِرِينَ. They said, put him off for a while and then send callers to all the cities of the state. جاتوك بكل سحار عليم, that they should bring to you every skillful sorcerer and magician. فجمع السحرة لميقات يوم معلوم. So the sorcerers or the magicians were assembled for the appointed time of a day which was already declared. That day, at that time, people should come, and then, you know, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam will be confronted with the magicians of Egypt. وَقِيلَ لِلنَّاسِ أَنْتُمْ مُجْتَمِعُونَ. And it was also called to the people, are you going to gather? That is, you should gather also over there. لَعَلَّنَا نَتَّبِعُ السَّحْرَةَ إِنْ كَانُوا هُمُ الْغَالِبِينَ. Maybe that we follow the sorcerers. If they are triumphant and they are victors. فَلَمَّا جَاءَ السَّحْرَةُ. When the magicians came, قَالُوا لِفِرْعَوْنَ, they said to Fir'aun, أَيْنَّ لَنَا لَأَجْرًا إِنْ كُنَّا نَحْنُ الْغَالِبِينَ. Shall we get some reward, some wages, if we are triumphant and we are successful over him? قَالَ نَعَمْ وَإِنَّكُمْ إِذَا لَّمِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. He said, yes, then you will be among the nearest persons to me in this state. مقربين. قَالَ لَهُمْ مُوسَىٰ أَلْقُوا مَا أَنْتُمْ مُلْقُونَ. Now, Musa said to those magicians, now, throw whatever you have to throw. فَأَلْقَوْا حِبَالَهُ وَعِصِيَّهُمْ. They threw in the field their ropes and their staffs. وَقَالُوا بِعِزَّةِ فِرْعَوْنَ. And they proclaimed, by the honor of Fir'aun, إِنَّا نَلَحْنُ الْغَالِبُونَ, we shall be the victors. فَأَلْقَى مُوسَىٰ عَصَاهُ. Now, Musa alayhi salam, he put down his staff. فَإِذَا هِيَ تَلْقَفُ مَا يَأْفِكُونَ. And suddenly it swallowed all that which they had concocted. فَأُلْقِيَتْ سَحْرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ. Now, the magicians, the sorcerers, were as if made to prostrate. قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. They said, they proclaimed, we come to believe in the Lord of the all worlds. رَبِّ مُوسَىٰ وَحَارُونَ. The Lord of Musa and Harun. قَالَ آمَنْتُمْ لَهُ قَبْلَ أَنْ آذَنَ لَكُمْ. Now Fir'aun said, you came to believe in him before I permit you. I allow you to do so. إِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرُكُمُ الَّذِي عَلَّمَكُمُ السِّحْرَ. He seems to be your chief who has taught you this magic and sorcery. فَلَسَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. So very soon they will come to know. لَوْ قَطْعَنَّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ مِنْ خِلَافٍ. I will definitely chop off your hands and your feet from the opposite side. وَلَوْ سَلِّمَنَّكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. And then I will crucify all of you altogether. قَالُوا لَا ضَيْرُ. They said, no harm. إِنَّا إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا مُنْقَلِبُونَ. We are turning to our Lord. Now you do whatever you want. إِنَّا نَتْمَعُ وَنْ يَغْفِرَ لَنَا رَبُّنَا خَطَايَانَا. We long only that our Lord may forgive us our sins. أَنْ كُنَّا أَوَّلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Because we are the first to become believers. Nobody else has believed and accepted Musa, but we are the first. We are, you know, we say that he is true. He is a messenger of Allah. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ نَصْرِ بِعِبَادِ إِنَّكُمْ مُتَّبَعُونَ. And then we sent revelation to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam that you take my bondsmen, my servants, Bani Israel, during the night. Surely you will be followed. فَأَرْسَلَ فِرْعَوْنُ فِي الْمَدَائِنِ حَاشِرِينَ. When the Bani Israel departed from there, now Fir'aun sent heralds and callers into the cities proclaiming, إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَشِرْذِمَةٌ قَلِيلُونَ. Surely these are a very small band. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَنَا لَغَائِزُونَ. And surely they are enraging us. Whatever they are doing, we are angry. وَإِنَّا لَجَمِيعٌ حَاذِرُونَ. And surely we are the host, fearful or awful. It goes both ways. We fear them or they are fearing us. فَأَخْرَجْنَاهُمْ مِنْ جَنَّاتٍ وَعْيُونَ. So we brought them out from their gardens and springs, وَكُنُوزٍ and their treasures, وَمَقَامٍ كَرِيمٍ and their noble places of dwelling, كَذَلِكْ. Thus it was. وَأَوْرَثْنَاهَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ. And we gave all these things to Bani Israel. Inherited. We made Bani Israel inherit all these pleasant things of life. فَأَتْبَعُوهُمْ مُشْرِقِينَ. Now the hosts and the armies of Pharaoh, they followed Bani Israel on the sunrise. فَلَمَّا تَرَى الْجَمْعَانِ. When both armies, now the Bani Israel going, and behind now Pharaoh has reached with his army, and both groups, both see each other. فَلَمَّا تَرَى الْجَمْعَانِ. When the two hosts saw each other, قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَىٰ إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. So the people with Musa alayhi salam, Bani Israel, they said, we have been overtaken. Oh Musa, we have been overtaken. Now there's no way. Now they will kill us all. In Torah there is that they became, you know, very angry with Musa. And, you know, they fought him against him. What have you done to us? Now here, we are going to perish here. We were better there. At least we were living. But now we will be killed. In Torah, this picture is given, not in Quran, which is not becoming of the messengers. فَلَمَّا تَرَى الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَىٰ إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. When the two hosts saw each other, the companions of Musa said, surely we have been overtaken. قَالَ كَلَّا. He said, nay, nothing doing. إِنَّ مَعِيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. With me is my Lord. He will definitely give me way. فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ. And we sent the revelation to Musa. أَنُدْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْحَجْمَهَرْ. You strike the sea with your staff. فَانْفَلَقَ. Then the sea parted. فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. And each part became like a mighty rock. فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. وَأَزْلَفْنَا سَمَّ الْآخَرِينَ. We brought near the others also now. When the army of Pharaoh is seeing that Musa and Bani Israel are crossing the sea because it has parted, and on both sides of this way there are the two rocks of water not moving. They have become maybe frozen by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe they might have become, you know, snow, and that was frozen. We can't say what happened. It's a miracle. And miracle is actually when the natural laws are broken by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But now they came. وَأَنْجَيْنَا مُوسَىٰ وَمَنْ مَعَهُ أَجْمَعِينَ. We delivered Musa and whosoever were with him, all them all together. ثُمَّ أَغْرَقْنَا الْآخَرِينَ. Then we drowned the others. We drowned Pharaoh and his hosts. إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَآيَةً. In this is a sign. If you want to know the truth, there are signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these things. There are signs all around you, in the universe, in the heavens, on the earth, everywhere, in the alternation of night and day, everywhere. You have the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you want to believe. But if you don't want to believe, nothing can compel you to believe. In the same way, these are the signs, historical proofs, historical signs. These are the history, this is history. The past, tazkir bi ayyamillah, the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. For most of them are not believers. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. And definitely your Lord is Al-Aziz. He's all-powerful. He can do whatever he like. But at the same time, he is Ar-Rahim. He's merciful. He doesn't want to show that evident and visible miracle so that their term comes to an end at once, immediately. He wants to give them time. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات وذلك الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.